Yo, it's time for a Seth nugget again. And I'm sorry, I do not know how to change these settings. It looks a bit like I'm in heaven. There's no filter on the thing. Yeah, who cares? It's about the Seth nugget anyway. And at the end of the video, I have a little surprise from you and for you. It's from the Netflix documentary from Shawn Mendes in Wonder. I stopped it halfway because I got inspired to do this video, and I can recommend it so far. I really like this guy. What a super beautiful human being. Anyway, watch until the end. It's about a minute. You're gonna like it. It links in with the Neville and Seth teachings. So this is again from the Facebook page, Seth, 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 and from a woman called Asuman Altan. She actually founded the page. And here it goes. Your feelings cause the events you perceive. In a way, the world is like a multidimensional. Okay, again. In a way, the world is like a multidimensional exotic plant growing in space and time. Each thought, dream, imaginative encounter, hope or fear growing naturally into its own bloom. A plant of incredible variety, never for a moment the same, in which each smallest root, leaf, stem or flower has a part to play and is connected with the whole. Even those of you who intellectually agree that you form your own reality find it difficult to accept emotionally in certain areas. You are, of course, literally hypnotized into believing that your feelings arise in response to the events. Your feelings, however, cause the events you perceive. Secondarily, you do, of course, then react to those events. And you have been taught that your feelings must necessarily be tied to specific physical happenings. You may be sad because a relative has died, for example, or because you have lost a job, or because you have been rebuffed by a lover, or for any number of other accepted reasons. You are told that your feelings must be in response to events that are happening or have happened. Often, of course, your feelings happen ahead of time because those feelings are the initial realities from which events flow. A relative might be ready to die, though no exterior sign has been given. The relative's feelings might be well mixed, containing portions of relief and sadness, which you might then perceive, but the primary events are subjective. It is somewhat of a psychological trick in your day and age to come to the realization that you do in fact form your experience and your world simply because the weight of evidence seems, underlined twice, to be so loaded at the other end, because of your habits of perception. The realization is like one that comes at one time or another to many people in the dream state, when suddenly they awaken while still in the dream, realizing first all that they are dreaming, and secondarily that they are themselves creating the experienced drama. To understand that you create your own reality requires that same kind of awakening from the normal awake state, at least for many people. This is from The Individual and the Nature of Mass Events, 1978. Yeah. Yeah, there are a couple of other things there that are not necessary to tell you. In the description, again, a copy of the text. I think I put the emphasis a bit wrong here and there. So please read it and listen to it again if you'd like. And now I will insert the clip from the Shawn Mendes documentary. I wish you a wonderful rest of the day, and I see you soon. Ciao! Mwah.
I went through a big phase where I used to write this over and over again. I control my brain with my voice. I sing with no tension. My chest voice is strong and healthy. This was 2 weeks before we put Rogers Center on sale, November 24th, 2018. I wrote, here we go. I will sell at the Rogers Center. I remember I was in this condo. And on November 25th, 2018.
And you wrote, I sold out the Rogers
Center. That's why this shit worked, because I wrote it in my manifestation.
Yeah, it was persistence.
It was persistency right here.